Scholars, before we announce the final group of trophy-winning teams at this Beijing Global Round, it is imperative that we take one final moment together as a community to thank those that make this community possible. We begin with a group that we honored at the beginning of this ceremony, but we could never honor them, never, ever honor them enough. And that group is, of course, the teachers of the World Scholars Cup community. Scholars, look around you. They've been watching you this entire ceremony. They've been cheering for your victories. Your victories are theirs. They are there to comfort you when things do not go as you plan. They're there to celebrate with you when they go beyond your wildest dream. And they make those dreams possible in the first place. Around you as well are waiting for you back home after your journeys come to an end. Are your families. Scholars, we would not be anywhere without the families that nurture us and launch us into this world. They give us that first seed of hope. They place their trust and their dreams in the future in us. And they have trusted you to this program, and for that, we thank them more profoundly than I can say. Scholars, please put your hands together for your families. Every one of you here attends a school. Some of you attend more than one school. Sometimes you have afternoon or Saturday or Sunday schools. But scholars, whatever school it is, to which you go when you wake up in the morning, or from which you come home in the evening, whichever school it is that says to you, this World Scholars Cup is a program that we believe you should be part of, or whichever school it is that doesn't know you're here but still sort of celebrates you when you get back. Scholars, to all those schools, we are so grateful. Please join us in saluting them, the schools of the World Scholars Cup community. And among the thousands of schools in the program around the world, and among the hundreds that are gathered in this hall, are some schools that have opened their doors to us as our hosts and friends in so many different places. Without those schools, we would not have places to call home for the program in so many cities, so different, in so many places that we wish we could be in every week. So, scholars, thank you. When you are home, think that the school that you're in has more than furniture. It has your future in its heart. And the World Scholars Cup all year long, but especially at events such as this one, could not succeed without the incredible hard work of individuals who are nothing more, and yet they are everything. They are nothing more than those who have given their hearts as volunteers. We never think about them enough. They do what you might call the quote-unquote dirty jobs of the World Scholars Cup. And if there's one thing we hope you have learned this year in the World Scholars Cup, it is that there's so many people out there who do not receive the respect, appreciation, acceptance, and love of the world at large. Know that the World Scholars Cup is grateful to you for all that you've done. Know that we could not do what we do without what you do. Scholars, here in China, we've been very grateful this year to be joined by an incredibly helpful partner organization, one that believes in the vision of the World Scholars Cup and has helped bring us to so many new corners of this great country. Please put your hands together for ASDAN. There are many things in China that I like that have the word Dan in them. They include ASDAN and Dan Dan Mien. This is not a narcissistic impulse, it is coincidence. We are also incredibly grateful here at this Beijing Global Round for our debate schools. You know, to find classrooms in which scholars can make their arguments, halls in which scholars can take the beloved challenge at this scale, is not an easy thing to do. In fact, we have yet to do it for Sydney. And here in Beijing, it was a great challenge. There are so many of you. And yet, three schools stepped forward to open their doors here in Beijing. We are so very grateful to the Beijing Royal School. They're one of the first schools to say you should have a global round here in Beijing. We are grateful to a school that jumped in the final few weeks when this round grew larger than we had anticipated, even in the face of visa rejections. We are so grateful to HD Beijing. One of my great friends, Jeremy, sometimes says that need can be the greatest motivator for help. And when we went to HD and said, we need your help, they said, we will help you. And so did another school that had already stepped forward to host a bit of our debates. But then when we said, we desperately need more space, they found a way to welcome twice as many scholars as they had planned. They did this for nothing more than the chance to help us. Thank you to Dulwich College, Beijing. Yesterday at the fair, a scholar came up to me and said, actually, it was a little bit before the fair. It was here right after the talent show. And he asked me how I was doing, how I was feeling. He said, maybe not many people ask you that during the week. And he's kind of right and kind of wrong. We're always asking each other how we're doing and trying to take care of each other. But it's also true that I hadn't had a moment to pause and reflect on how I was actually feeling. It's easy to say that I'm nervous in the first 2 days, and then kind of in the moment in the third and fourth, and sad at the goodbyes on the fifth and sixth of a six-day global round. But at the heart of it, what I feel at a global round is the joy that comes from spending 6 days working alongside my friends on the World Scholars Cup team. You are all such an incredible group of individuals. I don't know how you came together. I hope that you never go apart because they do it all. There are members of our team hiding behind that black barrier right there, trying to make sure that the video team here knows what to show on the screen. DJ Milo has moved from composing music to providing you with a soundtrack for your celebration. And every individual on this stage has traveled the world to be here with you. We never can thank them enough, but scholars, can we try? Please put your hands together for this incredible team at the World Scholars Cup. And of course, the reason this team comes together, we are motivated by the group to which we are most grateful. And that is you, the scholars of the World Scholars Cup. We are also grateful to your chairs. And now it is time to announce our overall champion teams. And to announce these teams, I'd like to call to the podium two friends whom I miss a great deal when they are gone, Chauncey and Dylan.
Scholars, we begin with 25th place in this junior division. That team is from Kaohsiung American School. Let's welcome team 6-4-4. They're also seventh place in the Far East region.
This is also a team number that holds much significance for some members of the World Scholars Cup. The 24th place team in the junior division comes to us from Bangkok's Ramruti International School, team 6-5-6. They are also eighth place in Southeast Asia.
Coming in 23rd place from the British School of Bahrain, it is team 222.
Also fifth place in the Middle East. Your 22nd place team is from Po Lung Kuk Choi Kai Yao, team 387. Sixth place, Far East.
Coming in 21st place from SJI Malaysia, let us welcome team 539. Seventh place, Far East. Ah, Southeast. Oops.
In 20th place, this is a team from the Island School. Give it up for team 376.
In 19th place, from Israel, from Rashish Junior High, team 466. Also, fourth place, Europe and the Mediterranean.
In 18th place, this is a team from Bahrain, from St. Christopher's School. It is team 238.
Fourth place, Middle East. Coming in 17th from Po Lung Kuk Choi Kai Yao School, it is team 388.
Fourth place, Far East. In 16th place, it is a team all the way from Egypt, from Cairo American College. It is team 362.
Third place, Europe and the Mediterranean. In 15th place, from King George the Fifth School, team 382.
Third place, Far East. And in 14th place, this team comes to us from Oman, from the British School Muscat. It is team 605. Another team number that holds significance to some other members of the World Scholars Cup, that might be me.
In 13th place, from Rashish Junior High, team 462.
And in 12th place, it is a school from Singapore, from Tanglin Trust. It is team 617.
Coming in 11th from SJI Malaysia, team 537.
And now, scholars, the top 10 in 10th place from Nanyang Girls High School, team 614.
Four. And in ninth, from Chengling Private High School, Team 513.
In eighth place, from the Rehoboth School for Gifted and Talented, it is Team 467.
In seventh place, from Harishri Vidyalayam, Team 434.
In sixth place, from Senri Osaka International School, Team 476.
And in fifth place, from Bahrain, from St. Christopher's School, Team 239.
And in fourth place, from one of our host schools, Dulwich College, Beijing, Team 752. They're also your first place team in the Far East.
Coming in third place, from Bahrain, from the British School of Bahrain, it is Team 213.
And in second place, your runner-up team in the entire junior division comes to us from what school? From Tanglin Trust. It is Team 616.
And now, scholars, there is one final team left to announce. Our champion team at this 2019 Beijing Global Round in the junior division, which is located at this CNCC, which stands for something, located in Beijing, which is located in China, which is located on Earth, which is located in space. That's about it.
This team is from...
This team is from Singapore. This team is from Nanyang Girls High School. It is Team 613. Scholars, make some noise for our champion team as they make their way to the stage.